Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to create this linen texture look for applying to your patterns in Photoshop. If you don't already know me, my name is Mel Armstrong. I'm an illustrator and surface pattern designer from Wellington, New Zealand. So today I'm going to answer a question that I get asked a lot, and that is how to create this linen texture on my patterns. And there are lots of ways you can create this, and a lot of people create them using filters in Photoshop or Illustrator. I actually created my texture by creating a pencil line and then turning that into a brush and then creating the texture pattern manually. And it's really easy to do. So let's first jump into Photoshop and I will just show you what it looks like to have this linen texture applied to a pattern. So in Photoshop here, I have a pattern on my screen. It doesn't have any linen texture, but over here in my layers panel, you can see a pattern fill. So let's just turn that on. And that, if we double click into it, is my linen texture. You can also see it up here in my patterns panel. I have a couple of textures, one's a smaller size and one's a bigger size. And then I just apply them to my patterns and then apply a blending mode. So for this one, I've got it on soft light. Sometimes I'll use overlay. Sometimes I'll use multiply, but that is going to darken this one. That would generally be for much lighter designs. You can also adjust the opacity. If I want a really strong texture, then I would turn that up. Or if I just want a subtle texture, I'll turn it right down. And if you zoom in, you can see the lovely texture there. So the first thing to do is to draw a line on either a piece of paper, or you could do it in Procreate. So I'm going to draw my line in Procreate, and we're going to turn that into a paintbrush in Photoshop. I've got Procreate open here. I'm just going to select a dark color, and then I'm going to select the 6B pencil, which is in the sketching brush library. And then all you need to do is just draw a straight line down, and I can let that snap into place and then tap my finger to make that a straight line. And I'm just going to add a little bit of taper on each end. You don't need to do that, but I recommend doing it. It'll just make it look a bit more organic when we turn that into a paintbrush. So first thing I need to do here now is to turn off the background layer. And then we're going to export this as a PNG to my computer. If you've done this on a piece of paper, you can just scan that in or take a photo and send it over to Photoshop on your computer. So let's jump into Photoshop now and have a look at that. Okay, so we're in Photoshop now, and I am going to turn this into a paintbrush. And to do that, I just need to select it. So I'm going to grab the rectangular marquee tool and just grab that, so make sure it's all enclosed in there, and then go to Edit, Define Brush Preset, and let's give this a name, and I'm just going to call it Pencil Line. And then if we go into our brushes, you can see here it's created that brush. And we want to modify the brush so that it creates the lovely linen texture. So to do that, go into Brush Settings. If you can't see that panel, go up to Window and then select Brush Settings. And the first thing I want to change is the Shape Dynamics. So I'm going to make the size jitter around 78. And you can see the difference it made. So at the moment, the brush is all one size, and then if we change the brush size jitter to 78, you can see that it is jittering the size of the stroke. I also want to change the angle jitter, but only slightly. If I go too much with this, it'll just turn it into a big mesh. So just a very subtle 1% is fine for that one. And the other one I want to change is the roundness. So if I show you that on 100%, you can see that it's created some long strokes and some short strokes. So I think about 76 for that is probably about right as well. And the minimum roundness, we can keep that at 25. Otherwise, yeah, I think that one looked pretty good at 25. And then we want to turn the flip X jitter and flip Y jitter on. and that just alternates the pencil line. And then the next setting I want to change is the scattering setting. So select that on, and I want to increase the scatter. So this is the distance, and this can go quite high. I'm thinking about 300-ish. And I might just up the count to 2. And then I want to add a dual brush. So let's just test this out at the moment. That's what it's looking like. It's quite clamped together. So if I add another brush, it's going to kind of separate it out. But I'm going to do this as a bit of an illusion. So I'm just going to select a brush that's kind of the size of a dot. So that one will do. And then just make sure all of these settings at their minimum so that you can't actually really see the dot. But it does mean that it gets spread out a bit. I might just try and find another one because that's still showing the dot. You might just have to play around until you find one. You're trying to make sure that there's no line going through the middle. So that one looks pretty good. I will keep it at that. Okay, now that we have all the settings, I'm going to add that as a new brush, and I'm going to call this one Linen Texture. And click OK, and then if I go to my brushes panel, it's added it there in the bottom. So to create the actual linen texture pattern, I'm going to create a new document, and for this it's a good idea to create it at the size that you would generally create your pattern. So if you generally create patterns that are 3000 by 3000 pixel, then create this as a 3000 by 3000. But maybe you create bigger ones, like a 12 by 12 inch. Just do what you normally would do. If you create patterns in different sizes, then you could create a few versions. I just recommend creating it at the size of what your pattern is going to be, so that way you know that it's going to repeat nicely when you put it on top of your pattern. So for this one, I'm going to create a 3000 by 3300 DPI square. And then we're going to turn on the pattern preview, and this will help us to create a repeating pattern of this texture. I also don't want to paint on the background, so I'm going to create another layer on top and then paint across. And you may need to adjust the size. If it's too big, it's going to end up too clumped up together. So you can just reduce the size as much as you like. This is quite nice. And then just paint across. Try and be consistent so that you don't get too many bits that are like too dark. But I find having a little bit of inconsistency makes it look even more organic. So I'm going to leave that one like that. And then I want to create a copy of that. So if I drag that down to the plus icon, that will duplicate it. And then use Command T to activate the transform tool. And then if I hold down shift, it'll snap into the horizontal. And now you can see this lovely hatch type texture, which looks pretty cool. I would also maybe bump down the opacity a little bit to maybe 70% on both those layers, so it's not so intense. And then the last thing you need to do is actually add it to your panel. So I'm going to click on the plus sign here in my patterns panel. If you can't see a patterns panel, just go up to window and select patterns and then add it as a linen texture. And then let's go and check out what it's going to look like on top of our pattern. So I've got my leaves pattern here. Let's zoom out a bit and I can just drag that on, make sure it's at the top, and turn on the overlay. I'm going to go with soft light and then just bump that down a bit. And there you can see it's created that lovely repeating texture. Now there were some dark spots in this one and I probably would have fixed them, but I'm actually quite liking the fact that it's got some inconsistencies in it. We know it repeats because this pattern is a 3000 by 3000 pixel pattern, and I haven't adjusted the size of this. It's at 100%, so it's going to repeat nicely, and I think that looks pretty good. So I would recommend creating a few different versions. So you can see when you're in that brushes settings, you could change quite a few things to change the look of it. And then every time you actually draw on here, see if I could add some more on here to even up some of those dark spots. It's going to change it slightly, so you'll have a slightly different texture. You can also flip your brush around, so at the moment it's facing that way, but I can come in here to this panel and flip it around, and then it will do the horizontal as well. And that way you don't have to actually create a duplicate. That's just a quick, easy way to do it. But now you've got this very organic linen texture using your own brushes, and you can apply that now to your pattern designs to create that lovely linen texture look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know if you have any questions in the discussion area below. You might want to check out this video here, which shows you how to use the pattern preview tool in Photoshop. Happy creating. See you later.